Assalamu alaikum students, hope you all are fine. Welcome to the new class. I'm your science teacher Shama Sami. Today we will start the first unit of this book. Open your science books. The name of the first chapter is Understanding Our Bodies. The learning outcome of this chapter is identify the major parts of body and their function. Describe how bones and muscles work together and help in movement. Identify the common disorders and their causes, and also suggest way to keep the parts of body healthy. Students, you know, a living body is like a wonderful machine. Just like a machine, living body is also made up of different parts. Machine use fuel, or it need fuels to work properly. Similarly, the human body need food to work properly. Each and every living organism need a proper amount of food to carry out their life activities properly. Your body is made up of different parts, and every part perform their own function, their specific functions. Bones and muscles is a part of your body, and it helps in movement. The second one is heart. Heart pumps blood around the body. The third one is lungs. Lungs helps in breathing and respiration process. Brain is a complicated part of the body, and it control all the processes which are in our body. Like other living organisms, the human body is also made up of tiny cells known as cells. There are millions of cells in the body. The skin, blood, muscles, and even every part of the body is made up of cells. Look at, I wonder, is there is any difference between the cell in our body and in animal body or plant? Yes, there is a difference between them. Animals and humans both are same. Humans are also a social animal, and they belong to the animal class mammals. So there is no difference between them. But in the cell of plant and cell of animal, there is a difference present. The plant cell contain organelles, chloroplast, which help in photosynthesis process because plant can make their own food. And it also contain the plant cell also contain a wall. We call it cell wall because plant are stationary and they can't move from one place to another place. So cell wall help them to protect them from extreme environment. Now we will discuss all the body parts one by one. Go to page number 3. Bones in the body joined together form a skeletal system. The skeletal system protect your internal organ like brain, heart, and lungs. Brain are protected by skull. Rib cage protects the lungs and heart. Skeleton also provide shape to your body, and it also support the body. Amazing fact, there are 206 bones in an adult's human body. The second one is muscles. Muscles in the body perform two type of function. The first one is it helps in movement. The second one is some muscles help in digestion of food. Some muscles help to the blood flowing. Some muscles help in lungs working. How muscles help in movement? When the muscles contract or relax, it move or come closer the bones. Muscle pulls the bone and thus produce movement. Students, there are two type of muscles present in our body: voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles. Voluntary muscles are under our control. For example, when we contract or relax our hand, these muscles are under our control. While involuntary muscles are those muscles which are not, we can't control them. For example, digestion in small intestine. Small intestine contain involuntary muscles. It is not in our control. Look at the amazing fact. There are more than 600 muscles in your body. I wonder, can we control all movement made by all our muscles? No, because some muscles are involuntary muscles, so we can't control all movement of the muscles. Lungs. Students, when you breathe, your chest move in and out. Inside the chest, there are two Heart is another important organ. It is made up of strong muscles and is about the size of your fist. The main function of heart is to pump blood all around the body. In this way, the body receives oxygen and nutrients, which are very necessary for all the organs to carry out their activities. The heart consists of four chambers: right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle. The right atrium and left atrium receive the blood entering the heart, and left ventricle and right ventricle pump blood out of the heart. The right portion of the heart, right atrium, right ventricle, receive deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood mean the blood having no oxygen. They take deoxygenated blood from the body and send it to the lung for oxygenation. The left atrium and left ventricle receive oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood means blood having oxygen. The heart receive oxygenated blood from the lungs through veins, and arteries take oxygenated blood from hearts and move toward the body. This movement of blood around our body is known as circulation process. The heart takes less than 60 seconds to pump blood to every cell in our body.